We've all heard the tale of the little engine that could. David Pogue has a modern variation that's truly out of this world.
And liftoff as the countdown to Mars continues.
In 2020, NASA's Perseverance rover launched for Mars.
And the vehicle has gone to closed loop guidance.
With a stowaway.
The helicopter, Ingenuity, actually stowed away on the belly pan. I don't know if you can see it.
It was a tiny 4-pound drone created by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. Travis Brown was its chief engineer.
This is the solar panel. And then moving down, we have what we call the web or warm electronics box.
I first met this machine in 2018 when it was still under development.
Why? What's it for?
We as human beings have never flown in the atmosphere of Mars, right? So this is like the Wright brothers equivalent, right, on Mars.
According to then project manager Mimi Ong, Mars has only 1% of the atmosphere of Earth. That's hard for a flying machine.
And the entire vehicle has to be very light.
Oh my gosh, it's like a dead leaf. I mean, I'm not kidding, this thing, I could blow this thing like a Kleenex.
NASA classified Ingenuity as a tech demo, a low-budget, high-risk side experiment, incorporating off-the-shelf parts to save money.
And was this idea of a stowaway technology demo under the rover universally, enthusiastically embraced?
No. No, it was not. There were definitely people against it, not just concerned, but wholeheartedly against it and trying to prevent it from happening.
Project manager Teddy Zanetos.
Mars 2020, to be fair, is a science mission. Go get some samples and prepare to bring those samples back home. Anything that's not that is taking away resources.
In the end, NASA decided that Ingenuity could fly briefly, 5 times tops in the first 30 days. After that, no more distraction from the main mission. By some miracle, Ingenuity survived the 7-month journey to Mars, the landing sequence, and the drop-off. Now, Mars is so far away that it takes up to 20 minutes for a signal to reach the helicopter, so every instruction would have to be transmitted in advance.
We'll uplink a flight on Monday, and we'll, if we're lucky, we'll get the data on Tuesday. Sometimes it's longer.
So for all you know, it's a smoking heap of wreckage
right.
on Mars,
right.
And you won't know till the weekend's over?
Yep, that's right. That happens all the time.
And so on April 19, 2021, the team waited for the news of the drone's very small first flight.
Altimeter data confirms that Ingenuity has performed its first flight of a powered aircraft on another planet.
But the hardest part wasn't flying. It was surviving the frigid Martian nights, 80 below zero Fahrenheit.
The joke is that Ingenuity is a battery and a heater that happens to fly once in a while. That most of the mass is battery. And most of that battery is actually spent heating.
Despite the cold, the helicopter flew 4 more times. 5 in all. Mission complete. But then, an administrative miracle.
When people saw this thing flying and taking pictures, you know, I think everybody realized this is more than just a toy. Right? This is a real flying machine.
Hovard Grip was the chief pilot.
NASA told us, hey, you guys get to continue. Can you scout on behalf of the rover so we can see where the best ingress points are into this area?
Ingenuity was no longer a tech demo. NASA promoted it to be the rover's eye in the sky, scouting ahead to help the rover choose its routes and destinations. So Ingenuity kept flying, kept beating its own records for distance, speed, altitude, duration, and not just for 30 days, for 100. 200, 400, through the long Mars spring, summer, and fall. But then winter came.
Tell us about Mars Day 427.
Radio silence. And so the first thing you're thinking is, okay, well, battery froze, everything broke, we're probably dead. Mission's over, right?
For 3 days, the team tried to get a response. And then, on the third day, another miracle.
In the morning, when the sun rose and the system thawed and charged up enough, the electronics turned on.
Lo and behold, it you know, came back and talked to us.
And we'll say, here's your flight plan, go ahead and fly now, late in the afternoon. And she'd do that flight, knowing full well the controllers here on Earth that she would freeze again the next day.
So the thing froze to death every night all winter?
Yeah.
And then thawed again in the morning?
For like, yeah, hundreds of times.
It was like Groundhog Day, right? So until finally you got through winter and you got to spring again.
But even Ingenuity didn't have an infinite supply of miracles.
The thing cannot last forever. I mean, so we were sort of ready.
This past January, NASA got the bad news. Ingenuity had suffered a hard landing.
The top blade is clipped on one side and completely missing on the other. We're missing enough of the rotor system, there's no way she'll ever fly.
Right.
Yeah. But, I mean, this thing is still ticking.
Well, you're using the present tense. This thing grounded. It's still alive in terms of sending you messages and data.
Yeah, I mean, I talked to it this morning. We can still collect solar data. We can take pictures still.
We have a phrase on the team, Wendy, we're not dead yet.
It's true. 3 years after its mission was supposed to end, the helicopter is still running, now as a ground station. We no longer receive its photos and measurements because the rover was its relay station and the rover has driven on. But Ingenuity could keep collecting data for decades to be retrieved later. The little copter that could has changed NASA's thinking forever.
We've been working on the next generation of helicopters for Mars, larger, more capable helicopters, and go to areas like a cliff wall, fly down a lava tube, go to the poles, go to the equator, you name it.
As for that Wright Brothers analogy, turns out the Mars stowaway helicopter harbored a stowaway of its own.
So the fabric used for the wings on the Wright Brother flyer, we have a little piece about the size of a quarter underneath the solar panel of the helicopter, and it's our little good luck charm and ballast for the baby.
And did everybody in the chain of command know that this was there?
No. I'm sworn to secrecy about certain details of that, but no, it was the entire chain was not aware of that.
In all, Ingenuity flew 72 times over the course of 1,000 days for a total of over 2 hours in the thin air of Mars.
It was a small, scrappy team of engineers, right? Very, very passionate about what they were doing.
It has a special place in the history of NASA for being the first flight on another planet, right?
We're all amazed. Everybody here is amazed. You know, we didn't expect it, and, you know, we're just really proud of it.